Hi, I'm Sean Dealey, front of house engineer for Sweetwater. Before joining Sweetwater, I spent 15 years touring the world with artists such as Counting Crows, Goo Goo Dolls, Avril Lavigne, and many others. I'm here to talk to you about getting a great vocal mix in a live setting today. Communicating with the singer is an integral part of getting a great vocal sound in a live mix. Choosing the right microphone for the situation will make a big difference in being able to get a great vocal sound in a live mix. Options such as dynamic microphones or condenser microphones will get you different results depending on the situation. A loud stage would be a more appropriate situation for a dynamic microphone. A condenser microphone might be an appropriate choice where you have a solo artist playing with a piano on a quiet stage. Speaking to the singer about microphone technique is a really helpful thing before you even start to get a sound. The closer they hold the microphone to their mouth, the easier it will be for you to get a louder, clearer vocal sound through the PA and the monitors. An experienced singer will hopefully have great microphone technique that'll help you get closer to the sound you're looking for. An inexperienced singer may not have the same technique. Understanding the challenges with that and being able to overcome them will help you get a better mix. Once you get to your console, gain staging is an important part of getting a great vocal sound. Setting your fader at unity and bringing up the gain until you have an ample amount of gain without any clipping will help you get a great vocal sound. It's also helpful to make sure that the singer has a good monitor mix on stage. Understanding what it sounds like up there will help you get a great sound out front. Making sure there's no feedback or any other issues on stage will help you have a clean vocal sound out front and allow you to get it as loud as you possibly can. One of the first things I do when I'm dialing in a vocal sound is use the high pass filter. High passing a vocal anywhere from 100 to 150 hertz will get you a clear, clean vocal sound. Using a high pass filter really eliminates muddiness in a vocal. It allows you to get a nice, clean, clear vocal sound that sits on top of a mix. When I use EQ on a vocal, I mainly use subtractive EQ, which means removing frequencies I don't want. Subtractive EQ allows me to control the vocal without compressing, eliminating problem frequencies and allowing me to get a cleaner, clearer vocal sound. It also allows me to focus in on frequencies that are a problem in a singer's voice. Sometimes there's frequencies that stick out more than others, and eliminating them allows me to get a smoother vocal sound in the mix. After I've gone through EQing the vocal, I'll dial in some compression settings. When using compression on a vocal, a little goes a long way. Compression ratios from 3:1, 4:1, 6:1 are appropriate for vocals. Things I find that make the biggest difference while compressing vocals are attack and release settings. Depending on the vocalist style and technique, attack and release settings will allow you to dial in a compression setting that is appropriate for the vocalist. Too fast of an attack setting on a compressor will take away any impact the vocalist has. And if the release setting's too slow, it'll stay compressed for too long. What we're looking for from the compressor is to help smooth out the vocal so it's more balanced in the mix. When I'm compressing a vocal, depending on the vocalist technique, I'm looking for anywhere between 3 and 6 dB of compression. I don't want to overcompress the vocal because it will get lost in the mix. Anything more than 10 dB of gain reduction will bury my vocal, and I don't want to do that. There are a few helpful tools in getting a great vocal sound. A de-esser helps control sibilance in a vocal, the S sound that may stick out depending on the vocalist. A de-esser is a high frequency limiter that helps tame problem frequencies in a vocal, a very helpful tool depending on the situation. Another useful tool for getting a great vocal sound is multi-band compression. A multi-band compressor is a 4-to-6 band compressor that has crossover points that allows you to control individual frequency ranges of a vocal. Multi-band compressors allow you to focus in on different frequency ranges and compress them differently. You can focus in on low frequency, mid frequency, high frequency, and compress them all differently with different attack times and different release times. Depending on the vocalist, this is a very useful tool in allowing you to control their vocal sound. Once we've dialed in a great vocal sound, we're now going to place it in the mix. This can depend on the genre of music and the vocalist style. Once we have a nice balance of the vocal, I like to add some effects to it. Depending on the style, I like to keep things subtle, but add some space and depth to the vocal sound. Reverb, delay, and pitch shift are some subtle effects that add space and depth to a vocal sound that allow it to sit nice in a mix. When choosing a reverb, a great place to start is with a plate or a hall setting. Adjusting the pre-delay and decay time of a reverb allows you to dial in an appropriate sounding reverb for the style of music you're mixing. There are several different styles of delay you can choose to use on a vocal. Mixing a few of them adds a nice but subtle effect. A short slap delay, somewhere between 80 and 110 milliseconds, is a great way to add a little bit of depth to the vocal. A great trick is to EQ the delay return so that it sits nicely in the mix. Another great delay effect is a ping pong delay. The delay return bounces from left to right and adds a subtle stereo movement to the vocal sound. Quarter note and eighth note delays can add a great texture to a mix if used appropriately. Pitch shift is a great subtle effect to use adding a slight chorus to a vocal sound. Blended in nicely, it will add some depth to the vocal sound. When using pitch shift, I like to alternate between up and down on left and right, usually somewhere between 10 and 20 cents in the vocal, and adding a slight bit of delay to it. I hope some of these tips and tricks help you get a great live vocal sound. Thanks for watching, and be on the lookout for more live sound videos from Sweetwater. If you like this content, please like and subscribe.